Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today, in today's video, we are going to see the runtime ONNX and how to do inference with a model transformed or converted in this format, and also how to quantize a model to work in this runtime. Essentially, we will be working with the V3 Mini from Microsoft, and we will see how to transform the original transformer version, the V3 Mini 128K, to a quantized version of Infor Integer. Okay, let's start. I have prepared, as usual, notebook with everything that we are gonna see here. First of all, we will install the runtime. We will follow the process. The more complex tasks that we are gonna do today is essentially install the runtime and prepare the environment. ONNX requires to you understand where you are working. And not only that, what you pretend to do and where and how you pretend to do inferencing with the ONNX model. Why I told you that? Because, well, the runtime is designed essentially, it's a cross-platform machine learning model accelerator, what they say described. No, it's ready to work. Once you have the model in this format, you can run it in different platforms, different architectures, with different languages. So the approach that they follow is train in Python, do inference whenever you want, and in the language that you want. It's not like that, because you cannot do it with all the languages, but you can do with many languages. You will see now in the documentation, I will pass you all these links. You can see here is essentially you can run models in Python, C++, C, C#, Java, JavaScript, Objective-C, or Apple devices, for example, Julia and Ruby. Windows, mobile. Well, it's impressive what you can. So you can load the model with any of these languages, and just once you have the model ready, so you can do inference with the model. So the all these languages have libraries which allow you to load a model, train it in Python or fine tune it in Python, and then on use it for inference in one of these languages. Apart of that, it allows you to run in different hardware architectures, not only CUDA, also TensorRT, OpenVINO, OneDNN, Qualcomm, Android. There is, well, MLGraphX. So a lot. Windows DirectXML, for those are familiar, this is a DLL that come directly in Windows. Is the evolution of the DirectX, the graphic accelerator that is in Windows. I don't remember since which version, probably Windows 95 already came with the DirectX to accelerate graphics in Windows. And, well, the evolution obviously is this library, which allows you to run again, code directly with Windows 10, Windows 11 for sure, and then you can just use it. No? There is a runtime which uses directly the DirectML library in Windows, and you can do inference directly with that. No? It's a little bit more slower than CUDA, but at the end of the day, you don't need to install anything. And it's quite simple to use. You just install the runtime in ONX, and that's all. later on, you install the correct runtime that support DirectML library, and you can run inference in Python in Windows without the need to install the CUDA toolkit. But well, that's a other story. So there is some of the pro execution providers that are maintained by the maintainers of the library, and there are others maintained by the community. I recommend you take a look to all this stuff because really the ecosystem is enormous, to what you can do with the with this library and with the different runtimes is really impressive. Something that definitely you have to have in your pocket, no? When you especially you try to use machine learning models in other languages, or you need you have a special requirement, and then all you know at the end the design interfaces in between components that are working in different languages are always difficult. Also load models or execute code in another language, for example, execute Python code in C sharp, for example, is possible, but yeah, it's quite but much more complicated. And then ONX runtimes allow you to just create the model in Python, fine-tuning again, create whatever you want to create, a computer vision model or an NLP model, use a transformer, use a generative AI model. Not all, I will show you now which ones are already prepared. And then on you transform it to ONX format, and then on you can use it in any with another application which is written in other languages. You just need to import the correct library. For example, if you take C sharp, you just well add the packages, and that's all. I'm gonna do some examples in other languages after this video because I'm working in the project for what I'm doing all this stuff where we are gonna use the P3, the V3. We majoritarily the code is C sharp, and then I really intrigued to how to. I know a little bit of C sharp and not an expert. I can read the code and I understand what's going on, and also can write very slow, not like Python. Python, I'm much fluent. But I will use these some of the examples to do to try how it works in other languages, probably as well in Java. And Java I'm a little bit more familiar, and I see here that it's also possible to run in, where is that here, iOS custom build, no, generate API. I saw that it's possible to run ONX in Raspberry Pi. Ah, here, exactly. IoT deployment on Raspberry Pi, and this is something that I would like to try as well. We will see later if I have time. I will do something with Hugging Face. I already have here done part of the pre before to do the tutorial with the V3. I did some stuff with a transformer, and I show how to convert the model into this format and use the runtime for transformers. And then, well, I will prepare another video. And but today we will work with the V3 in ONX format. So for generative AI, as you see here in the documentation, there is a specific special section here, and then you have to use a specific library ONX runtime JNI, which allow you to work with these models here. Models like this and derivants, because code llama, for example, Vicuna, they are similar to llama models, and then you can work with them as well. So what is supported now? Gemma, Llama, Mistral, and Phi. And then APs, Python, C#, C++, Linux, Windows, Architecture, and Hardware Acceleration, CUDA, and DirectML. This library is designed by Microsoft, so you see what is the direction of everything that they are doing. Essentially, they create this library to be able to use, because you are working in Azure environment, there is many applications without running in C#, and also because this is, for example, if you are working with Azure Machine Learning Studio, you can work with C# or with in other technologies as well. And well, if you had a model, a very good model in Python, but you cannot load it in an application in C#, you had to create an interface. Well, you can do it, but yeah, it's much more complicated. It's easier, like you see here, just load the model in this format and use it directly. You train in Python and you use it in C#. Very, very good approach, and I think it's going to be very successful. You see here the roadmap, what is under development, ARN64. This is for edge devices and embedded devices, which is also probably one of the most demanded today requirements, most demanded requirements today. So we are going to use this. The first thing that we will see on the tutorial is how to install it. You need to have, again, you need to understand exactly how is the environment where you are going to do the inference or to do the transformation to install correctly the libraries that you will use. So in this environment is a Colab Pro with a L4. We don't need that bigger GPU, but well, it's fine. Here we have a CUDA toolkit, NVIDIA SME. So we have a 12.2 CUDA toolkit. So we need to install everything in CUDA 12. So additionally, here in this environment in Colab Pro, we don't have QDNN. This is another library from NVIDIA. So you need to install it. We will see it now. And again, first of all, we install the conventional runtime with the correct CUDA support. We are going to create a CUDA runtime. You can create 4 different runtimes. Or the most common are CPU. With this runtime, you can also execute purely in CPU. You can, obviously, the model is smaller, which increment the speed. You can run in CUDA, in GPU, you can run in DirectML, the graphic library in Windows, and you can run as well in web. No? Then on all the architectures, all of them, as you can see here, let's go back. You go to another runtime, execution provider, every execution provider, for example, OpenVINO, you know, had a specific runtime. If you are going to run there, we need to install this. There is also support Windows, Linux, support for C++, C#. So take a look, understand your environment, because, yeah, not every execution environment had different requirements. The most easiest ones are, again, CUDA, CPU, and Dark ML. Those are the easiest ones. And you will see that even being the easiest, they are really a little bit, not very complicated, but you need to understand what you have in your environment. Okay, let's start. We here again, we install the conventional runtime with GPU support. I'm pointing to the right CUDA toolkit version. Then on we install the rest of the libraries that we are gonna use. We install the runtime Geni with also CUDA support 12. You had everything on the documentation. And just you go to Python. You have here how to install the runtime, how to install the GPU, GPU 12, etc. If you go here to Generative AI tutorials, you have here tutorial 3, you have how to install it, CUDA, etc. Okay. Here, if you follow this, here they are not saying anything about DNN, but I told you, if you don't have DNN installed, QDNN, it will not work. At least you need to install this. The way to install it, you install QDNN 9 with the support of the CUDA version 12, and also install Celic V1G. And once you have both, you have everything that you need installed in your machine. Here again, runtime Geni CUDA with CUDA Toolkit 12 and also the QDNN 9 CUDA 12. Once you have this, we just check what we have installed. And here, the runtime comes with some, modules or classes to help you to understand. First of all, if you have everything correctly installed, you just execute machine.info and it's going to tell you what you have and if there is any problem, CPU, GPU, memory, OS, Python, packages, runtime, and PyTorch, TensorFlow libraries. PyTorch ONNX support is integrated in PyTorch. You don't need to install anything, just installing PyTorch. Is coming with the support. You can export models to this format directly. For TensorFlow, you install an additional library. It's explained on the now. What first of all, we are going to try with a model already transformed to the format ONNX. So I'm going to take this repository in Hugging Face, and I download it here to this path. If you check the path, we had three main folders. One is CPU and mobile, and there you had the models for to run in a CPU. You have here the models to run in a CUDA device, in a GPU, and you have here the model to run in a runtime Dart ML. So this is an option, and the second option is just pointing with the, you can do this with the Hugging Face CLI. And just include the folder of the model that you want to use. In this case, I just downloaded to this other folder, ONNX, and then on there, forget we had this is the transformation that we will do on the end. The model that you download is only the version CUDA integer 4. This is what we download with this command here. Yeah. This one. And then once we had the model downloaded, it's pretty fast, it's taking nothing. You just import the runtime, the Genai runtime. You load the model. It's also going very fast. Create the tokenizer, tokenizer screen. Here we pass some parameters. This parameter is for the flash attention mechanism to use it. For those that are not familiar, we had a video on the channel what we explain this how it works, the flash attention mechanism. You want to, if you are interested on that, let me know in the comments of this video. And then we create the prompt, we tokenize the prompt, this tokenized input, we pass it as parameter here. You see there is a special model parameter generator, which is essentially a dictionary. And then you pass to the generator, the model, and the parents. This is if you want to use streaming. And if you don't want to use streaming, directly take the model and use the method generate and pass the parameters. In the parents, remember that we already had the tokenized prompt. Here I make a try. Just let's take a look again. We do a try. Well, it's just a simple way. You can do it that way, or you can use it with the generator. The generator is just generating the next token up to the generator get the end, and you generate essentially the same. So this runtime, you can set which available providers you have. This is for the conventional runtime, not for the generative AI runtime. Let me check if we have Augi. No, we don't have the same method in the other runtime. Or let me 1 second. Second, J1 just to test. Yeah, exactly. Okay. Oh yes, we can try OG. No, but OG, I remember that there is not this method in OG. OG that. No. Let's check. No, it doesn't have this method. It's another library, as you can see. This is the conventional runtime. The runtime that we are using in this example is the GenAI runtime for generative AI, and doesn't have the same method. It's smaller. Okay. The next that we're gonna do is to use the model, the builder, to transform a model from transformer into a quantized version in ONNX format. And this is done with the models builder. You can do a help here. There is different options. The input is the name of the, or either the path in your file system or the name on Hugging Face Hub, sorry, model name. Input, you can have a Hugging Face or GUF path. You can use one or the other, model or input. Output is the folder where we will put the transformed model. The precision, integer 4, floating point 16, floating point 32. The execution provider, only these 4, CUDA, CPU, DML, or web. And different options as well here, which allow us to optimize and speed up the execution of the model. I didn't use anything so far. But yeah, it's probably worth it to take a look to if you need anything specific. Especially if you are working with Integer 4, to avoid that well the loss in precision is here we use Integer 4 the you lose a lot of precision, so you need to be very accurate to don't spoil the model, say that, no? Here we install some of the libraries that we need, especially transformers and accelerate. You need as well the flash attention library. Here I need to do a login in Hugging Face, and essentially here what I took the builder, I used this path, Microsoft V3 Mini 128K. This is the output. The precision is Integer 4 and a runtime, a CUDA runtime, and then on the TMP is the cache. Just you execute it and we'll start to scan. Start to download the tensors from Hugging Face, and then on read all the layers. You had the embeddings, decoders, normalization layer, and Elmer head. And we start to save it in ONX format, and you can see here we are transforming every layer into Integer format. And once you have it at the end of the process, you just simply can download it exactly the same that we did before, pointing to the folder, create the tokenizer, parameters, and generate. And here, well. And basically is that. You see, it's not very complicated. Once you have the runtime installed and you have cleared the path how you are gonna use it or where you are gonna use it, you install the pieces that you need and you just either transform or use the model ONX. Again, I'm going to prepare some of the tutorials with this runtime because I think it's really really powerful, especially in other at least for non conventional environments. When I say non-conventional, it's because I don't work with them usually. I would say C# or Java or Raspberry Pi. These environments, I did some stuff, but it's not something. Usually everything I am is Python. We did in a previous video, we will try working with ONX format in CPU and DirectML. You had the video on the channel already with the V3 as well. So if you want to see how it works, it's exactly the same that you see here. No, nothing different. If you don't find it, let me know. I will point you out where is the video. You can check and verify the speed of the model running processing architectures. But I want to try two different things more. One is working with another language with a model that I already transformed here in Python, and secondly working in another architecture like Raspberry Pi and see what we have there. And well, that's all. Thank you very much for watching the video. Keep you tuned here to the channel. I'm publishing every day new stuff, shorts and new stuff about generative AI, computer vision, MLOps. Again, that's all. Thank you very much. If you like the video, give me a like. Subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Share with your friend and colleagues just to help me to promote the channel in YouTube. Thank you very much. Bye bye.